still on.
He's the youngest, and the others have all played in college, and his brother is the star quarterback at Palm.
Oh, wow.
You know what, which brother it is? I saw it. We had a, what's that piece that you had here?
It's Jared is at Carter, right? The four chapters.
He's got Lee
Colton. Jared's at Georgia.
Jared's a walk-on at Georgia.
Colson? Nah, I came back on.
I guess record-setting quarterback.
Wow. Came back on. It was off.
There's Slate. The first one? Doesn't list any stats.
Oh, Lee.
He played at Georgia Southern and North Alabama.
There's a team on his team, right?
What is that? That's not something that I'm
the
yeah.
game.
Yeah.
No, it's not up.
All right, so here's what we want to do. Turn the audio board off.
Turn it off?
Or can you mute it? Where's the mute?
I thought it was just when he put the head thing.
Testing. All right. Do it now. Testing.
Good evening and welcome to this edition of GHSA Play On Sports. This is the high school football playoff game between the Greater Atlanta Christian host Spartans. They're going to be taking on the Model Blue Devils out of Rome, Georgia. Both these teams come in with a pretty even record. Greater Atlanta Christian coming in the 7-3, Model with a 6-4. The tail of the tape just to get you caught up on how the season's gone so far. Model mainly runs the ball. They don't throw the ball that much, whereas Greater Atlanta Christian will come out in an I formation normally. They'll drop into the shotgun every now and then with quarterback Rafe Chapel throwing to Peter Whiteneck, Darius Slayton. Also, David Elrod will get in there every now and then. But the tail of the tape, as I said, Greater Atlanta Christian head coach Tim Hardy, no stranger to the playoffs so far in his career. He's coached five NCAA championship teams. I beg your pardon, five NCAA teams to go to the playoffs before reaching right here at GAC. This is his first season at GAC, and a 7-3 record is pretty good to boast so far. Hi there, my name is Ben Poplin. I will be bringing you all of the action tonight live as you see on the field right now. The Greater Atlanta Christian Spartan, Marching Spartans. They will lead us in a rendition of the national anthem and the fight song in just a moment. For Model, head coach Gordon Powers is no stranger to the team. He was with the team under head coach Lynn Honeycutt for a couple of years. Before that, he was head coach from between 2003 to 2008. Then in 2012, right back here, he reached the playoffs. Before they reached the playoffs, it was 2003. Once again, the first year he was the head coach right here at Model. It's going to be a very interesting matchup tonight. We're very excited to bring it to you for Play On Sports. Once again, I am Ben Poplin. It's going to be very, very interesting to see both of these teams. Two similar styles of play. They come out of the power eye normally, a 4-3 defense. It's going to be interesting to see how both of these coaches play mind games with each other. A couple of different strategies every now and then throwing out. You'll see some timeouts. Once again, Rafe Chapel, though, for the Spartans. He's going to be someone to watch. He'll drop back in the gun every now and then. He will pass friendly. He will run whenever he wants to if he's pressured, which he has felt a lot of pressure this season. GAC coming off a loss to Lovett, 31-30 last week, which dropped them to the number 2 seed in the playoffs. They would have been region champs, which they were back in 2001, 2002, I believe. I'll check that in just a moment. But as I said, GAC no stranger to the postseason. Model, on the other hand, 2003, the last time, 9 years ago, that was the last time they reached the playoffs. And talking to Gordon Powers earlier, he seems very enthusiastic about this team, their athletic directors, everyone, all the statisticians, everyone just excited to be here for Model. On paper, both the teams look pretty even. A 7-3 record again for GAC, a 6-4 record for Model for first-year head coach Gordon Powers.
The Marching Spartans and the Spartan fight song.
Both the teams will come out of their respective tarps. The Marching Spartans are going to play a rendition of the GAC fight song as their team comes out with a 7-3 record again, Model 6-4. Pretty good crowd on hand here at GAC. The facility's beautiful, the AstroTurf field. Something you're seeing much more of in high school football. Now, I grew up playing on grass, but a lot of teams nowadays are making the switch to AstroTurf. It's much easier to handle, much easier to maintain. And that Spartan, very evident at midfield on the 50-yard line. You will see that all night long. And Spartans painted in the end zone on both ends. Right here at GAC. It's always interesting to see what the tarps say, or I beg what the banners say as both teams run through. A lot of them playful gags towards the other team, a lot of snags. Both of those teams will be running out shortly as we will get this one underway. Model versus GAC. As you're watching this game, you can follow us on Facebook and Twitter, both social media at PlayOnSports, and hashtag GHSA Football is what you can follow along. I'll be trying to tweet along toward the game, letting you know what's going on if you're not watching it. Once again, follow us on Facebook and Twitter at PlayOnSports, hashtag GHSA Football. Public address announcer taking it over right now for GAC. He's announcing the starting lineups. We'll get those to you momentarily as well, as we are just under about 5 minutes to go. It's going to be a ceremonial prayer led by the PA announcer first, and then we will honor our country with the national anthem. Keep it here. We will be right back as he will lead us in a solemn prayer. That was a beautiful rendition of the national anthem played by the Marching Spartans of Greater Atlanta Christian. Now you'll see both of the banners raised as both teams will run out in support of their team. Mainly a GAC fan base here, but a couple of Model fans have made the trip out. Once again, the last time the Model Blue Devils did reach the playoffs was back in 2003. Now, going through the lineups, a couple of players to watch on each team. You're going to see Rafe Chappell, the quarterback on the GAC team. He will hand it off to Kyle Scales more times than not. He'll throw every now and then. He'll drop out in the shotgun. You'll also see Corey Stevenson come in and take a couple of snaps. Fullback Carruthers. A funny story with his jersey. He used to wear number 36, but he ripped it earlier this season, and he has to change his number to number 48. So that's what you'll see. He's not listed in the roster as number 48, but Carruthers will be number 48. Also, you'll see Darius Slayton out to the left in the slot and Peter Whiteneck. Both of them will go out for passes every now and then, running slants, post routes, and you'll also see tight end Lewis, number 83. For Model, you'll see a mix of running backs and a mix of quarterbacks. You'll see Caleb Woods, number 5, as well as Tyler Dean. You'll also see Cameron O'Neill, number 2, every now and then come in, make a pass. But Model mainly runs the ball. They don't throw the ball a lot. They'll hand it off to senior running back Nakia Watkins and his brother Nikhil Watkins, sophomore, every now and then, number 35. The interesting thing about both of those running backs, Nikhil Watkins, 1,015 yards rushing this season with his brother Nakia, 642, but Nakia was sidelined a couple of weeks ago with a knee injury, so that's something you'll see watch. Also, Jamal Milligan, number one, is someone Model will hand it off to. He's very small, about 4'9", maybe even 5 foot. He's very fast, can get around that corner, beat defenders to the side. As you see in midfield, 50-yard line, captain shaking hands. You'll see the coin toss in just a minute. We're about to get underway. Talking about Kyle Scales for the GAC Spartans. On the season, he has 1,063 yards receiving, 16 touchdowns. Peter Whiteneck on the other side, 643 yards receiving, whereas Rafe Chappell passing to him, 1,618 passing yards for 17 TDs and only 5 picks. His brother, an interesting story about him, his brother was a quarterback at Harvard. Brother Colton, the starting quarterback at Harvard, and he is... Football really runs in his family, especially at GAC, as his grandfather's great-grandfather, a couple of his brothers, both played here at GAC. Another receiver you'll see him throw to, Chris Williams, 556 yards receiving on the season. Like GAC has won the coin toss. They have elected to receive. They'll take it to the right side of the field. Model will kick it off. That'll be C.J. Jackson, number 7, to kick it off. Saw him practicing early in the game. Kicking from the 30-yard line. That's about as deep as he will go. If he goes to 35, he's probably narrowly going to miss it. Not a big boot. And there come the Model Blue Devils out of their banner. Very exciting for them. The players talking to Gordon Powers, very excited. They feel like they can win this game, and everyone's right behind them, especially from the town of Rome. And now you'll see hashtag Spartan Nation, everyone getting in on the Twitter as GAC will come out in just a moment, flagged by a tunnel of marching Spartans. And here they come. The football player from Greater Atlanta Christian High School. 7-3 on the season. Model Blue Devils 6-4. We're about to get underway. GAC has won the coin toss. They will receive. Model will kick off. Think about the GAC and Model. Model mainly consisting of a lot of lower classmen. They have a lot of sophomores, so it's very impressive that they have a 6-4 record, as the lack of experience really not showing anything. They're very aggressive on the field. You'll see Nakia Watkins run the ball, but he's also a presence on defense as he's a linebacker. He will get around the offensive lineman, show that quickness. And you'll see Paul Swords serve as the fullback and also get around as well. Both teams taking the field now. They will line up. The Model Blue Devils will kick it away. A couple of words from C.J. Jackson and the officials. He will plant the ball, kick it away from the 40-yard line. You'll have Peter Whiteneck and Darius Slayton back at the 10 and their 5-yard line, respectively, to receive it for the Spartans. Good crowd on hand here at GAC, Greater Atlanta Christian High School. It's a chilly Friday night, but that's what you get with high school football, especially in the playoffs. And Jackson kicks it away. It is a pooch kick, and it's handled by Pickens for GAC. That's something you see from Model. They don't kick it deep a lot. It's handled by Pickens. Ross Wood was also in on that, and the GAC offense will take the field for the first time tonight, led by quarterback Rafe Chappell. He will hand the ball off a lot to Kyle Scales. We'll also have Whiteneck and Slayton out to the side, as well as Elrod, to throw a lot. They will take it from the 40-yard line, around the 45. And they'll come out in a single-back formation model with a 4-3. Waiting for the whistle, it is blown. And here is the first play of the playoffs for both of these teams here in 2012. Chapel takes the snap, hand off to Scales, takes it a couple of yards, maybe 4 or 5, and he will be brought down around the 43. That ball will be on about the 45, 43-yard line. Good pickup for Scales already in the game early on. You're going to see a couple of those runs. He'll mix in a pass every now and then, but he'll break out. He is very quick, and now you'll see, as I said, Rafe Chapel will drop out in the shotgun. Three receivers to the right, one to the left. Joss Bat looking for Whiteneck to the left. On the run, complete to Slayton, down the 50, 55, 45, and he will be brought down around the 45. Good pass, presence in the pocket for Rafe Chapel that time, moving to his right, scrambling as he saw the pressure coming. He looked for Whiteneck on the left, good coverage in the deep by Model Blue Devils, and he hits Slayton in the slot to the right for a gain of about 10. First down, you see Whiteneck already out there on the 45. And the rest of the Spartans break. And you'll see Chapel stay out in the shotgun. Why not? It worked. Flank to his left. Running back sends someone in motion. Fakes the handoff. Drops back. Takes it himself. Going to have to run. He's past the line of scrimmage and down to about the 39. Good pick of about 5 or 6 for Chapel that time as he called his own number, kept it himself. You see Paul Carruthers checking in now for Corey Stevenson. You'll see a handoff to him every now and then. Once again, Whiteneck out to the left. It's going to be a second down. Chapel staying out in the shotgun. Flank to his right, Scales. Takes a snap, pressure coming on, handoff. Good job by the Model defense to just stuff him. He was gained about 2 or 3 yards, but Model saw it. They brought the blitz and just brought him down around the 35. Kyle Smith, number 25, the tackle for Model that time. It'll be a third down. See how GAC does with their back against the wall here. Third down. They come out an eye handoff. He is going to pick up a couple of yards. And that will be a first down for the Spartans. Good job of picking that up, showing their back against the wall. Chapel looking over to the sideline to Tim Hardy. First-year head coach Tim Hardy giving the plays. A lot of quarterbacks you see in high school will wear the wristband. He is wearing one, but he's looking to Hardy for the plays. As you see Carruthers getting rid of a piece of clothing out there on the field. It'll be Carruthers, and it's not Scales. I'll tell you who that is in just a minute, lining up for GAC. Chapel's going to take it himself. Quarterback keeper sneak right in. Model wasn't full, but looks like he's going to pick up a couple of yards and keep this drive moving for a first down. Conversion, the chains have moved down to about the 30-yard line. Chris Williams checks in. He's another one of those receivers you'll see for Whiteneck. He'll line up to the left with Whiteneck, number 3, and Slayton to the right. Spartans come out in an eye. Doesn't hand off the Scales. Rolling to his left. Pass complete to Williams. He'll be down around 25-yard line. A good pass. Williams ran a good route that time to the left. Model had no answer for it. Ball will be on the 26th. And now you see Corey Stevenson checking in for Carruthers. The thing about GAC is they have a lot of players on that sideline, you see, whereas Model, a pretty small team. Hand off, picks it up, and he'll be down around the 20-yard line. Early on here in the first quarter, 8 minutes, 18 seconds to go in this playoff matchup between the Model Blue Devils and Greater Atlanta Christian Spartans. Carruthers checking in now for Stevenson. As I said, GAC has a large bench, so they can check it in if any of the players get winded. Ball will be on the 20. GAC will come out and eye again. Model in a nickel formation. Fakes the handoff. It fooled everyone, and the pass wide open, and the tight end just missed it for GAC. Play action fooled everyone. Model was bringing the pressure, and it just fooled everybody. That pass intended for tight end Andrew Lewis. He's a senior, and he just dropped it. It was right in his hands, and he just dropped it. That kind of catch has to be made, especially in the playoffs. You never know, and kicking is going to be very important. You might see the kickers come on here in just a minute. Brandon Holscreve on the sideline. Chapel come out on the shotgun again. It's going to be second and 19. Sends a receiver in motion to the right. Looked like Model might have moved on the left, though. Whistle was blown immediately. We'll hear the call from the official in just a minute, but it did look like Model moved on the defensive side of the ball. Model's pointing over to the right, but it looked like they moved. It will be called on them, and that's going to be a 5-yard penalty. GAC move even closer, get close to the red zone as Lewis comes back in at tight end. Wide net looking for the direction of the coach. Chris Williams coming back out. Now he won't drop in the shotgun. He'll come out in an eye. Snap. Down the 20 to the 10, and a good run all the way down to the 5-yard line to the left. The sweep to the left. Model didn't have an answer for it, and great blocking by the offensive line of GAC as they will be in the red zone for the first time today, the Spartans. Something you're not seeing. They're not handing the ball off the scales. Micah Abernathy is in there, number 4. He's a sophomore. He's getting a lot of running. You don't know if he's hurt, but he is in there getting the ball. Dropping out in the shotgun again, this time in the red zone. Takes the handoff to Abernathy. Breaks a couple of tackles. He might have gotten in, or he might have been down right at the goal line. Model with a good defensive stand. Touchdown was not signaled, so you're going to have another play. A good run that time by Abernathy, but Model just stopped him right at the goal line. You're going to come out in an eye again for GAC. A couple of running back flank to his right. The handoff to Abernathy, and he is in. That'll be your first touchdown of the playoffs. Actually, I thought I saw a referee signal, but Model with a good defensive stand trying to force them to get a field goal, and those are huge in high school football. I thought I saw the ball break the plane, but I beg your pardon. Got a little bit ahead of myself, and now you see a third and goal, inches to go. Rafe Chapel might take it himself. He does, to the left, and that time he is in. No need for a signal as the confetti flies in the crowd here at GAC. The band playing, the crowd going nuts. 6:40 to go here in the first quarter, and GAC strikes first blood. You'll see Brandon Holscreve come on for the PAT. He was practicing early on, and Rafe Chapel, I said it earlier, he is not afraid to run. He kept that one for himself, called his own number. And a good drive that time by GAC. Model just really had no stop all the way down the field. Holscreve lined up for the PAT. Ball is hiked. Good boot. It is in, and it's a 7-0 lead for the host GAC. Crowd going nuts. And Model, if you look for Model, they really want to answer back. As GAC has a good kick. They'll kick it all the way downfield. Last time in their game, Lovett, there's deep men, Darius Slayton, Peter Whiteneck. They did not want to kick it to him, so Lovett pushed it to him every time, just like Model did, and that's respect for the special teams they have for GAC. Great drive by GAC that time. Handed off to Micah Abernathy, a couple of passes to Whiteneck and Williams down the left side, but it was really the running game that put everything together for GAC during that drive. Holscreve sets the ball up. A very chilly night. You see him trying to get some warmth. It'll be James Brown back on the 10 to receive if they do kick it to him for the Blue Devils. There's the whistle. Holtzgreef set to kick it off. Motions to both of the sides. And he does kick it deep. But the whistle blown before. They're going to bring it back. We'll have to do it all over again as the official blew his whistle. Not sure what the call is on that. Going to have to get a new ball. They're going to scoot him back just a little bit. The ball might have actually fallen off of the tee. As the wind very strong out here. 6:40 to go in the first quarter. GAC taking an early 7-0 lead. Holtzgreef back to kick it again. This time from the 35. Whistle blown right in the middle of that kick. Chris Williams flanked to his right. See how the special teams for both teams stand up. Brown back to receive it again for the Blue Devils. Ball stays on the tee that time. Not kicked to Brown. He's going to pick it up on a bounce, though. Take it all the way to the 30, 35, and around the 32-yard line. He is picked up and tackled by the GAC Spartans. So we'll see this model Blue Devils offense for the first time tonight. Led by quarterback Caleb Woods, you'll also see Tyler Dean and Cameron O'Neill in there every now and then. But they'll be handing it off to one of the Watkins brothers, Nakia or Nakyle. Nakyle, a sophomore, Nakia, the senior, who has struggled with injuries, a couple of knee injuries during the season, so he hasn't run the ball as much. 642 on the season, whereas Nakyle, his brother, 1,015 yards. And you'll see Caleb Woods and the model offense coming out in an eye. Hand off. He's going to be dropped. Couple of yards that time. Nakyle Watkins with the run. Picked up by the GAC defense. It's going to be second and about 8. Model still coming out of an eye. GAC defense. Not afraid at all. Pickens back. Sends someone in motion. Hand off again to Kyle. Off to the left side, but he is picked up. If he got any ground, he saw a lot of green daylight, and he might go all the way down the field, tie this up. But good job by the GAC defense to pick him up on the left side. And that sweep, no answer for it. You'll have a third and short, third and 7. Third and 5, I beg your pardon. As model, not even attempting to pass. Let's see if they try to here with a 3rd and 5. Sometimes when they do have to pass, model will bring in a Cameron O'Neill or a Tyler Dean. Caleb Woods, though, will stay in. Send someone in motion. Pitch it to Nakyle. He will get, I don't know if he'll get 5 there. He might have gotten 3, maybe 4. The chain's right there. They might measure it. This GAC defense, they're going to wave it off, though. Paul Carruthers on the tackle. You'll see him serve as a fullback as well. And it looks like they did give them the first down. Caleb Woods will be back under center for the Blue Devils as they pick that one up. 5:09 to go here in the first quarter. GAC leads 7-0. Takes the snap, pitches to Nakyle Watkins again. Gain of about 2 or 3 yards into just the edge of that helmet on the Spartans' 50-yard line. Back to the 42-yard line. You'll see a 2nd and about 8, 2nd and 7. As Mono didn't pick up much on that running play. You'll see Kyle Smith go in motion a lot for the Model Blue Devils to the left. GAC defense, though, doing great so far. Now you see James Brown come in for Kyle Smith. He'll head to the sideline. Both of them flip-flop throughout the game. Austin Price to the left, flanked. Have not passed yet, the Model Blue Devils. Fakes the handoff to Watkins, then a handoff to James Brown. He'll go down around, again, the 44-yard line. Not much picked up that time. Jake Rose on the tackle, number 51 for GAC. He'll head to the sidelines, a little winded. And now James Brown, you'll see him flank outside as a wide receiver every now and then. Caleb Woods gets the call from head coach Gordon Powers. And he will drop back in the shotgun formation, something you don't see the Blue Devils do a lot. Takes the snap, feels the pressure, dumps it off. A good move. He'll get all the way down to the 48-yard line. A good job by Model that time. Felt the pressure, got rid of it. You saw a screen pass to the running back, and a good job on Kyle Watkins to get a good gain. Got more than enough for the first down that time. He's going to have a new set of downs on the 48. Model back in an I formation now. GAC not being able to stop. Woods trying to call the make the defense come off sides. Didn't work. Looking over to the side again. Managing the play clock. Still looking to Gordon Powers for the play. Still looking. And it looks like Model will call the first timeout. 2 minutes, 43 seconds left here in the first quarter. GAC leads 7-0. They couldn't get together on a play. Model's Gordon Powers and Caleb Woods, and they burn the first timeout of the game. And with that timeout, we will take a quick timeout right here on Play On Sports. Bring it right back here. GAC leads 7-0 early on first quarter, 2:43 left to go. Back with you at Greater Atlanta Christian High School. Model was going to go for it on fourth, but it looks like they'll set the punter back. And GAC, with a good stop on defense, they will elect to punt it away. Peter Wagnett back. Bad snap. Fumbled. And he's going to be tackled all the way back on the 30, maybe the 29-yard line. And GAC, they caught a break that time as it was a bad snap. And he couldn't get away from the GAC rushing defense to get a punt. And they will have perfect field position all the way down on about the 29-yard line. And GAC, it's about 10, 15 yards from the red zone again. They could come out, take an early 14-0 lead. Only 5 seconds passed on that last play as Model just really shot themselves in the foot. A bad snap. Gives it back to GAC in great field position. Chapel will come out again in an eye. Hands it off, sweep to the left, dodges a couple of tackles. He'll go down all the way back down to the 22-yard line. A good game, about 4 or 5. For once again, Micah Abernathy, we're not seeing Kyle Scales today run the ball at all. We don't know if he's hurt or anything, but we haven't seen him on the field yet. Maybe look for him a little later on. See Brandon Holscreef along the left side of the field practicing his kick a couple of times just to see if he'll be called upon. Clock ticking, 2:06 left to go in the first quarter. As GAC trying to milk the clock, go into the second with an early 14-0 lead. Chapel will drop back in the gun again. Flank to his left, Micah Abernathy. Couple of receivers to his right, Whiteneck to his left. Bad snap, but he handles it. Try to hand it off to Abernathy, but the flag was called before the play could resume. See who's it on. It's going to be on the offense. GAC, that's not good for them as they had great field position. They're going to shoot themselves in the foot, move all the way back as you had one of the offensive linemen move a little bit early. As you see, Whiteneck, an interesting thing about Whiteneck, he looks over to his own coach, a wide receivers coach on the left, to get his own play, and Chapel with the rest of them in the huddle. Chapel will come out in the shotgun again. This time Abernathy to his right sends him past to Whiteneck, off to the 30, down to the 20, about the 18-yard line. A good pass, good pickup, as Whiteneck just really a quick out play, stood right where he was. No one picked him up. dodges a couple of tackles. Good blocking on the play, and he picks up about five or six. 1:19 to go here in the first quarter. Again, GAC threatening to take an early 14-0 lead. It's a third and two, third and short. Carruthers checks back in. Beg your pardon, that's Trevor DeDecker. And the handoff to Abernathy again. Gain of about one, maybe two or three. He'll go down to the 17-yard line. He will get the first down very easily, very handedly. Clock ticking still. 45 seconds to go here in the first quarter. Play clock not running yet, as you might see them just milk this all the way down and then run one more play before the buzzer in the end of the first quarter. GAC again coming out of an eye. Chapel under center, DeDecker. Hand off to Abernathy, and he is stopped. Barely gets to the line of scrimmage that time, maybe a gain of one if he passed it. And that will bring it, actually the clock stops. 19 seconds to go in the first quarter. Short pickup for Abernathy. You're going to see a new set of downs, a first and 10. Whiteneck again looking to the side, get his own play. He'll flank to the left of Chapel, see if he comes out in the shotgun. Chapel will actually flank to the left. He's going to be a wide receiver. You might see a wildcat as they were going to try, but the clock ticks all the way down to the end of the first quarter. And with that, it's a 7-0 lead for Greater Atlanta Christian. They're controlling it right now all the way down to the 2018-yard line where the ball 7-0 lead. We'll take a quick timeout as they switch ends on the field. Keep it right here. Play on sports. We'll be right back. Back with you with GAC. They're going to take over on the other end of the field to the right, still on about the 18-yard line. While there's a break in the action, though, for all the best coverage of Georgia football throughout the playoffs, visit WSBTV.com. That's WSBTV.com for all the sports and highlights from Georgia high school football. Chapel out of the gun, sends Whiteneck to the right. Pass complete. All the way down to Darius Slayton. First time he's touched the ball down to about the 9 or 10-yard line. Good pickup for GAC and Models defense. Just really flustered and frustrated out there. Really don't have an answer for the GAC offense right now. Early on in the second quarter, just underway. 11:50 to go in the first half. You'll see Lewis, as well as DeDecker, check back in. Lewis tight end, DeDecker fullback. Chapel does get the play from Tim Hardy. Whiteneck be flanked to the left. You always saw Darius Clayton to the right. Slayton, beg your pardon. The lineup in an eye. He pitches it, and Abernathy dodges a tackle and into the end zone. It is a 13-0 lead for GAC. Good pitch, fooled the defense, sweep to the right, and Abernathy, all he had to do was dodge one tackle, and he did so pretty handedly as he gets into the end zone, and you will see Brandon Holscreve back out for another PAT attempt, taking an early 14-0 lead. You got to be happy if you're Tim Hardy, head coach of the GAC Spartans right now. Holscreve set up. He did hit on the PAT last time, and it's an instant replay. Does it again, and that is early 14-0 lead just began the second quarter, 11:24 to go. That the drive in total maybe lasted about 10 minutes, but only two or three plays. That's all it took heading into the second quarter here. 14-0 lead for the Greater Atlanta Christian Spartans. Model, you really have to score right now just to take a sense of pride. Keep yourself in this game. Gordon Powers knows that, too. Spoke with him earlier today. Very excited about this, but he's realistic, too. He knows what his team has to do. You watch pregame interviews, very serious, even if his team wins. Holsgrief making sure to get that ball set up on the tee right as it fell over earlier because of the wind. Don't know what the wind chill is out here, but it's very chilly tonight. Wouldn't want it any other way, though. Georgia High School playoffs. It'll be James Brown again back to receive for the Model Blue Devils on about the 8-yard line if he does kick it that deep. And there it is. It will get all the way to Brown. He'll take it around the 10. Oh, and he fumbles it. They've done it twice now. Model can't make the catch, and he will have terrible field position as maybe at 2 to 3 yards on that kickoff return. And I don't know what it is, but Model just cannot catch a snap or any catch right now. Terrible field position. If GAC can get a 3 and out, they'll be in great position to take an early 23-0 lead, 21-0 lead. I know Model likes to run, and I know Gordon Powers has that certain Lynn Honeycutt-type playing style, but sometimes you're going to have to throw, and this might be one of those times. Austin Price flanked out to the right. No one to the left. Handoff, and he is stuffed. He won't pick up anything on that. Be lucky if he got to the line of scrimmage, as GAC's defense just smothering anything Model throws at it right now. Pickens, the free safety, hasn't gotten in on anything because he hasn't even seen a pass yet in the back, as well as Ross Wood. Darius Slayton to the left. Nope. They haven't, to the right, they haven't gotten any work so far. As Model, they're not afraid to throw it, but they just it's just not in their playing style. As Caleb Wood. Looking at his wrist, getting a play. They line up in an eye. The handoff, the pitch to Nikhil Walker. Actually, he keeps it himself. And he maybe got a yard, maybe two on the play, and it will be a third down in GAC. Looks to be in good field position if they can make another stop here on third down. As Model offense, just nothing doing for him early on in this game. 10:17 to go in the second quarter. And now you see Jamal Milligan will check in. And he's only in if he's going to run, and he will get to that side very, very quickly, and he's short. You can barely see him amidst all the tackling and all the big offense and defensive linemen. Woods is back out in the shotgun. No handoff. Milligan out. Pass complete. Down to the 20, maybe 25. Gets to about the 22-yard line. I don't know if that will be enough for the first down. As you will see, James Brown come out. I believe he is the punter for the Blue Devils. Actually, he was one of the receivers that ran a slant route all the way to the left, and Wood just didn't find him. Peter Whiteneck back to receive it for the GAC Spartans. Second time Model has had to punt it away. 9:15 to go in the second quarter. GAC leads 14-0. Whiteneck back at the 45-yard line. Punt is away. It won't even get to Whiteneck. Wood says wave it off. Model's going to have to pick it up. It's going to take a roll almost all the way back to where Whiteneck was standing. He could have caught it and not even moved, but it's going to go right to the 45, maybe 46-yard line. And GAC offense will take the field again. You got to feel confident if you're them, if you're Rafe Chapel. You've completed every pass you've thrown except one to the tight end, Lewis, and that was just butterfingers. He dropped it. The handoff to Micah Abernathy, though, it has been working all game long. You haven't seen Kyle Scales, but at this point you don't really need him as Abernathy controlling this model defense. GAC lines up in an eye again. Carruthers, Abernathy doesn't take the handoff. He's going deep, wide open down the field, caught by Whiteneck. He's going to get into the end zone. And a 20-0 lead for GAC. The play action fake worked perfectly off to the left. Whiteneck beat his defender all the way down the left side of the field, caught it about the 10, and he only had 10 yards to go. But there's going to be a flag on the play, and you hear the boos from the crowd, as that is a heartbreaker for GAC. Whiteneck had no one around him. The flag all the way back at the line of scrimmage, though. You're going to move back about 10 yards. That's unfortunate because GAC Whiteneck wide open into the end zone. It'd be a 20-0 lead with 8:48 to go here in the second quarter. And Carruthers rots back off as well as Lewis. And that's something GAC is not afraid to do, is go deep, take a shot downfield, and it works if your offensive lineman doesn't move. Handoff sloshing all the way to the right, down to the 50, almost to the 50, brought down right at the 50-yard line. Abernathy with a great run to the right. Dax Bishop on the tackle for the Blue Devils. He has 9 tackles per game is what he averages. And Micah Abernathy, another great run. And he'll take a breather on the sidelines as he has a sweep to the right out of the shotgun formation. Caught the model defense off guard. And that's something the GAC offense has been doing all night. 8:12 to go here in the second quarter. GAC lines back up in an eye. Model just seems confused out there. Off to his right. Good pass complete to Whiteneck down to the 40, all the way down almost to the 35-yard line. As Whiteneck, again, just finding ways to get open. They just cannot conceal him at all. Caleb Woods on the tackle. Also the quarterback for Model on the tackle for that one. And Lewis coming back in. You'll see him maybe flank out to the right as Chris Williams will take a breather. For GAC, 7:54 to go in the second quarter. GAC doing a great job of managing the clock. Slayton out to the right, Whiteneck to the left. Also Lewis the tight end. The handoff. Actually, he keeps it, feels the pressure, and he is sacked. Big play by Model that time. Good play. That was number 44. Justin Nelson on the sack, and that's a big play for Model. As the play action fooled him earlier, that's just a sense of pride right there. Good job by Justin Nelson. Chapel trying not to let that happen again as he will most likely, nope, he will drop back in the shotgun again. Flank to his right, Micah Abernathy. Got Slayton, Lewis, Whiteneck, feeling the pressure again. Did he get rid of the ball in enough time? Interception Model, but did he get rid of the ball in enough time? That will go as an interception. No, actually, that's called an incomplete pass. He did get rid of the ball in enough time. So that's a huge break for GAC, as Model had a sure interception, and that would be a big break as it's 14-0. It's going to be a 3rd and 14. Sure to throw here as flank to his right. Abernathy again, 6:53 to go in the second quarter. Two receivers to his right, one to the left. Drops back, plenty of time to throw now. Trying to get it to Abernathy in double coverage. Beg your pardon, he was trying to get it to Chris Williams in double coverage, and he could have took a shot downfield. You had Slayton and Whiteneck in the end zone. But a good defensive stand for Model, as that will bring on the punting unit for GAC. The first time they have been stopped today on offense. Now if you're Model, you look to recap regain anything. You get 14-0. You can get back into this game with a score, cut it in half to a one-possession game. Right now it's a two-possession game. Ross Wood will be back to punt. One of the best punters in the nation, I was told earlier today. He'll punt from the 45-yard line. Caleb Woods back to return it. It's a decent punt all the way down to, wow, all the way down to the goal line. And GAC will pick it up. You couldn't have had a better roll. That took a perfect GAC roll there. And Model will have terrible field position right on their own goal line. And they're sure to run it. If you throw it, you don't want to risk an interception. Only a couple of seconds ticked off the clock that time. 6:34 to go in the second quarter. Model takes over at their own goal line. GAC gets a safety. That's an early 16-0 lead. Definitely in the back of the mind if you're the Model offense. Want to avoid that. Your quarterback, Caleb Woods, get rid of the ball in some way. Throw it away. Just do not get sacked. And if you do, get back to the line of scrimmage. Woods will line up. Austin Price to the right. The only receiver. And he runs it, keeps it himself just to get out of the goal line, get a little bit better field position. He'll get maybe a yard, maybe two on the play, and it'll be a second and nine. Yeah, the ball moved maybe 1-2 yards that time. As Model just looking to get out of their own goal line. It's second and nine. Second and eight, beg your pardon. And Woods, again, lined up in an eye, has no one in motion. There's someone in motion. Kyle Smith to the right. He throws it to him. Complete. Maybe got a couple of yards. It's still going to be his third and a good bit of yardage to try to get down. That one maybe got to the 5, maybe 6-yard line that time as Smith was flanked out to the right, went in motion. It's one of the first times, maybe the second, third time we've seen the Blue Devils throw tonight. Not a pass-happy team. It seems like every time the Blue Devils do pass, it's just shut down immediately. Now you see Price out to the right again. The only receiver in motion. The only receiver for the Blue Devils. Pitches it back to Watkins, and he is going to be stopped. Maybe gets to the line of scrimmage, but gain of one. They're going to have to punt near their own red zone as they will not pick up the first down there. You see if they want to go for it or not. Whitenett getting ready to receive it in the backfield. He's trotting on. Coach calls him back. Looks like Model will go for it. They're not going to punt it away. And I do kind of understand this, as you don't want to punt it away. You don't have that much confidence in your punting game, but you will bring the punting team on now. And just look for him to get the punt at least 20 yards. You'd be happy with that as Whitenett lines up around the 45. Hasn't had a chance to return it, as the last time it hit him, it stood right in front of him and rolled. Punt is away. It's decent, but it gets to the 40 and bounces out of bounds. And again, GAC will have good field position with 4:41 to go in the second quarter, leading 14-0. The only time Whitenack has touched the ball today is he had a touchdown, but it was called back for an false start on his own team, his own offensive line. And Chapel and the GAC offense will take the field again with Micah Abernathy having a ton of yardage so far tonight. Model defense with a good defensive stand, though, something to build upon in that last drive as they held GAC to a three and out. Come out in an eye, handoff to Abernathy to the 30, and he will be picked up down on the 26-yard line, a good gain, about 11, 12 yards that time, and an easy pickup of first down as the blocking just opened up holes to the right, and Abernathy saw him, picked it up, First down for the GAC Spartans, moving the chains. As you see them have an easy, a good mix of pass, run, and pass for the GAC Spartans, but I don't know why you wouldn't give the ball back to Micah Abernathy as well as he's running today. And just because they're coming out in a shotgun now doesn't mean they're not going to give him the ball, sweep it to the right, maybe an off tackle to the left. Oh, pitches it to Abernathy, and he is picked up. Gain of about one, maybe two on the play. Chapel fakes it, trying to pick it up, going to his left, and then he pitched it to Abernathy. Didn't pick up much on the play. It'll be a third and seven. Chapel rushing onto the field with 3:45 to go in the second quarter. His team leading 14-0. Has a couple of receivers to his right. Chris Williams, Darius Slayton, Peter Whiteneck to his left, still out of the gun. Hand off to Abernathy. Dodges a couple of tackles, still going. Down at about the 9-yard line, a good, solid run. He will get the first down, and GAC will be in the red zone again, and they've been perfect from the red zone so far today, scoring twice. Corey Stevenson has checked in now for GAC, as you may see him get a handoff every now and then, as Abernathy has just been running rampant all day long, all night long for GAC. He's going to stay in the shotgun formation. Why not? Because it's working. Running back and fullback, flank to his right, Whiteneck to his left. Takes the snap. Double clutches. Pass complete to Peter Whiteneck, and he gets that touchdown back. He double clutched, faked the defense out a couple of times, and Whiteneck was open in the back of the end zone, and that is a 20-0 lead for GAC. And going into it, you didn't know who was going to be favored, but on paper, it looked like these teams were two evenly matched teams, but right now GAC controlling it. 3:02 to go in the second quarter, first half, 20-0. And Holzgreef on for the PAT. He's been perfect so far. Add another one, it's 21-0. Greater Atlanta Christian controlling everything. Confetti flying in the crowd. Holzgreef, one of the best kickers you've seen in high school football. Rafe Chapel, perfect pass to Peter Whiteneck in the back of the end zone. Model defense, frustrated, angry. You just really want to get on the board. You don't want to be shut out in the playoffs because you think you deserve to be here. You want to show people that. Holzgreef will kick it away from the 40. And if you go into halftime with 3:02 to go, if you go into halftime being shut out, you're going to have what's called a come-to-Jesus moment from Gordon Powers, and he is not going to be happy about how the way his team's playing right now. Holzgreef set to kick it away. James Brown back to receive it around the 9. Everything GAC has been doing, they've been stopped one time on a 3-and-out, and that was 2 drives ago. But that drive was just perfect. Kick is away. It'll get to Brown. Catch it around the 5, down to the 10, the 15, the 20, and he would brought down. No, he's still up. Down to the 35, down to the 36-yard line. Dodged a couple of tackles. Thought he was tackled down, but a good return. That's a sign of life from the Model Blue Devils. As anything positive you're really clapping about right now if you're the Blue Devils. As Caleb Woods and the offense will take the field again, trying to just get on the board. 21-0 lead for GAC, 2:52 to go in the first half. Model on their last drive, pass it a few times, and it did work. So maybe you see Caleb Woods drop back in the gun or take a couple of two-step drops, maybe an out to his right. Completed it to Kyle Smith one time. Austin Price, still the only receiver to his right. Lined up in an eye. Sends a motion to his right. Handoff to Nikhil Watkins, and he is going to be brought down about the 45-yard line. A good gain, about 5 or 6 yards on that one. Clock still ticking, though. 2:38 to go. Model running out of time to try and get on the board before halftime. GAC defense, though, you cannot let up. You're leading 21-0. Yes, it's a three-possession game, but you cannot get up, give up. You can't just let up and fall laxed. It's high school football. Anything can happen. It's Caleb Wood still has Price flanked to his left. Then someone in motion. The handoff to Watkins again. Down to the left. Dodged a couple of tackles off of his feet. Down to a 47, maybe 48-yard line. Gain of about four that time. Good run by Nikhil Watkins. We haven't seen Nikhil Watkins run any again because of his injury. He's been injured a couple of times during the season, his knee. So they've watched that closely. He hasn't been on any tackles on defense either, so not sure what the tail of the tape is for him right now. As Austin Price flanked to his right again. Hand off to Nikhil Watkins and down again to the opposite side of the 50. Gain of about three or four again, so the chains are moving. For the Model Blue Devils, 1:47 to go in the first half. GAC leads 21-0. You're watching Play On Sports. It's going to be a second and six for the Blue Devils. Another handoff to Watkins. Flanks to the right this time. Dodges a couple of tackles, and he'll be down to around the 38-yard line. Good run. Another gain about 10 or 11 that time, and you just cannot stop Nikhil Watkins right now if you're the GAC defense. He's got 1,015 yards coming into this game this season. He's only a sophomore. The future is very bright for this young man. Minute 20 to go here in the first half. Look for him to hand it off to Watkins as many times as they want, as many times as it works. Fakes the handoff, gets to him, and DAC saw it. They saw the fake. They knew it was coming, and he is brought back down in the backfield. Loss of one or two. It's going to be a third and maybe eight or nine, as Model will. They'll probably be forced to throw here, and you don't want to give the ball back to GAC with this much time to go. 46 seconds to go. Model's going to have to go for it. Doesn't make the handoff, drops back, going deep. Intercepted by the GAC defense. Pickens down to the 40. The 45, the 50. Dodges the tackle. He'll go down to the opposite side of the 50 to the 40, and a great interception by the GAC Spartans. And that is why Model doesn't throw the ball a lot. Not a lot of confidence in their passing game. With 26 seconds to go here in the second quarter, GAC can make it a four-possession game. 21-0 lead, Greater Atlanta Christian. They can go into halftime leading 28-0. That's making a statement if I've ever seen one, as they lost a heartbreaker to Lovett last week in the region championship. 31-30 dropped into the number two seed, but they're showing they're a force to be reckoned with tonight. Rafe Chapel out of the gun. Passing. Avoids a would-be tackler. Takes it himself all the way down to the 40 to the 35. He's going to be out of bounds around the 36-yard line. A good run for Chapel as he saw the pressure, avoided it, scrambling to his left. 16 seconds to go. He was knocked out of bounds, so the clock stopped that time, and you don't know if you want to see him run it or they might take a pass, take a shot downfield to Peter Whiteneck again or Chris Williams. You haven't seen him. They know Peter Whiteneck. You also have Darius Slayton to your right. Still coming out of the shotgun. 16 seconds to go. Second quarter. GAC leads. Takes the snap. Pass over the middle. Intended for, it looked like, Chris Williams. And it just a little bit behind him. And he couldn't make the catch. Clock did stop. It's 12 seconds to go now in the second quarter. 21-0 GAC lead. Third down. If you can get close enough, Holscreve can hit it within about 30 yards, and you're going to see a timeout for Greater Atlanta Christian. That's a smart timeout, as you want to know what kind of play. Do you want to go for it? You want to try for the touchdown, or you want to get close enough to take a three from Holscreve? With that timeout, We're going to take a quick timeout here on Play On Sports. You're watching it. It's 21-0, 12 seconds to go, second quarter. Keep it right here. Back with you once again for this playoff matchup between the Model Blue Devils and Greater Atlanta Christian Spartans. It's a third down and short. They're going to elect to try for a pass. He drops back, takes it himself, stumbles a little bit. Got to run. Oh, and the flag was thrown in the background, though. Not sure what the play was. He almost crossed the line of scrimmage, though. Got to be careful. He cannot pass past the line of scrimmage, and it's going to look like a holding call on the GAC offense. So they're going to have to punt it away. And that's unfortunate because if you get the pass complete, you're close enough for a field goal, as Darius Slayton was right there on the 30-yard line, maybe a couple of yards back. And that's going to move them back all the way to the 50. Chapel staying on the field, though, as GAC going to go for it. Going to have to do a Hail Mary with 4 seconds, 4.6 seconds to go in the second quarter. You're not going to see the punting unit come on for GAC. They're going to air it out. No secret what they're going to do. Model's going to throw everything but the kitchen sink at him, as they have about eight cornerbacks on the field. A dime defense. He drops back, feels the pressure, and he is going to be hit down, sacked around the 46-yard line. And that will be the end of your first half, as the Model Blue Devils have nothing to show for this GAC offense and defense. They've been smothering. It's a 21-0 lead going in to halftime for the Greater Atlanta Christian Spartans. We'll be back here in just a little bit to talk a little bit of the stats, a little bit of everything going on that's wrong for Model and everything that's going right for the GAC Spartans. So keep it right here. About 20 minutes, we'll be back for the beginning of the second half. back with you, about to begin the second half of play. Greater Atlanta Christian leads 21-0. And the tail of the tape, what happened in the first half was GAC was just clicking on all cylinders in offense. Micah Abernathy, the running back, don't know the stats, but he ran for at least four, maybe three or four yards average a carry every time, and Model only was able to stop him a few times, whereas Rafe Chappell, the quarterback, was just firing at will. He only threw two incomplete passes, I beg your pardon, one to tight end Lewis, and just slipped out of his hands, butterfingers, and then another one intended for Darius Slayton on the right, or Chris Williams, I beg your pardon, as he was crossing the middle. He just threw behind him a little bit, but he did complete a pass to Peter Whiteneck in the end zone for a touchdown. Micah Abernathy ran for a touchdown, and then he ran for another touchdown. And that's about it. That's all that's happened. Whereas the Model Blue Devils, their running game was showing signs of life early on, late into the second half. Nikhil Watkins was running, and he was running consistently, gaining about 5-6 yards a carry, and GAC just couldn't stop him. But then the half ended. So you don't know if Gordon Powers really pulled him off to the side, spoke to him on his own, because he was really carrying the team. And if you're Model, I know you're afraid to, or you maybe not be afraid to, but you're not a pass-happy team. You're going to have to throw the ball because this running game, Nikhil Watkins is a great running back. He can't carry the entire time, though. His GAC defense has proven they can stop him. So Caleb Woods is going to have to throw the ball, or maybe they even put in Tyler Dean or Cameron O'Neill, but they're going to have to pass. Right now, as I speak, Cameron O'Neill warming up on the sideline throwing, so you may see him to come in and pass. And Model's going to have to do that, and they're going to have to do something different, as whatever they were doing in the first half didn't work. 21-0 lead, Greater Atlanta Christian. They will kick it off to Model, and if you're Model, you really want to get the second half started off right with a great James Brown return. He had one early back in the first half. He came all the way down to the 40, maybe the 43-yard line, and look for him to do that again, trying to put this team on his back. As Model is down 21-0. It's a completely different half of football, though. It's high school football. Anything can happen. Brandon Holsgreave set to kick it off. We're about to begin the second half of play. The winner moves on even further in the playoffs. The loser, I believe, is eliminated. First time Model's made the playoffs since 2003, whereas GAC has made it a couple of times over the past 3 or 4 years. The kick is away. It'll get to Brown. He'll pick it up around the 5, down to the 20, 25, 30. He'll be picked up and down around the 26-yard line. So a decent return. And here come the Model offense. And we'll see if Caleb Woods is under center or if maybe Tyler Dean or Cameron O'Neill. See if Model wants to change something. As I said, whatever they were doing in the first half did not work. Nikhil Watkins really the only bright spot for Model in the first half. It will be Caleb to come under center. Caleb Woods, Model lined up in an eye again. Austin Price flanked to the left. The handoff to Watkins. Good gain down to about the, honestly can't tell, almost to the 35-yard line. Gain of about 3 on the play. A good run, but, again, you're going to have to pass it sometime. The running is not going to carry you the entire game. That's just underway in the second half, 11:30 to go in the third quarter. Austin Price will move to the right this time. Still coming out of an eye, the Model offense, Caleb Woods. Look for another handoff. Actually, fakes the handoff to the fullback. Was going to pitch it to Watkins. He just didn't do it, and GAC wraps him up in the backfield down past the 30-yard line, and that's going to be a loss of about 5 or 6. That's not what you want if you're the Model offense. And now it'll bring up a long third down. And unless they can convert, they'll have to punt it away, and GAC will have good field position as the Model kicking team and the special teams in general, not that great. The best punt they've had came all the way down to the 40. They were punting from about the 20-yard line, and it rolled right in front of Peter Whiteneck's feet. And Caleb Woods out of the gun. takes the snap, drops back, a little screen pass to Watkins, down to the 25-yard line, maybe the 35. Not going to be enough for the first down. And you will see the punting team come on for the Blue Devils. Not the way you want to start out this second half as GAC defense stops them again. And Peter Whitenick will be back around the 45-yard line to receive the punt if it gets to him. It backs up now to the 40, all the way back to the 35-yard line now. He'll no doubt have to scoot up. Yep, he comes up to the 40, makes the catch. He is tackled, wrapped up immediately, did not make a fair catch call, didn't really have time to. So Model tackles him back around the 30-yard line, and GAC won't have that great a field position this time, which is something you haven't seen from them so far today. It's been basically a meadow of flowers for GAC, to use an expression. I don't even know if that's an expression, but to use that, GAC has basically had perfect field position every time they've gotten the ball tonight. This time, they'll be back on the opposite side of the 50 for the first time. Micah Abernathy still back there in the eye. Rafe Chapel look for a handoff to him. Peter Whitenick, Darius Slayton in the slot to the left and right. Handoff to Abernathy. He's wrapped up immediately, and Model has caught on to that game. That's not going to work anymore, as Model's defense saw it coming, brought the pressure, and brings Abernathy down almost immediately after he touches the ball. So now you maybe see a pitch or a sweep or maybe a play action, and then you go deep. But that handoff to Abernathy did not work that time, as Model's defense wrapped him up immediately. Slayton and Elrod to the right. Peter Whitenick to the left. Handoff to Abernathy. Sweep to the right. Gets the gap all the way down to close to the 50. A good gain by Micah Abernathy, as that time it did work. Sweep to the right, and it's worked all game for them, that sweep move from the shotgun formation. And Model didn't see it coming, because you really can't see it coming with Rafe Chapel's arm. You don't know if he's going to go deep, because he's got a cannon for an arm, and you don't know if he's going to hand it off to Abernathy, who could slice and dice like the rest of them through tackles. Good blocking by the offensive line for GAC as well to break those gaps and close Abernathy, led him to get a good gain. Another handoff to Abernathy. This time down to the 50 and the 45. That's a gain of about 4 or 5 again. It's going to be another 2nd and 5 as Abernathy still moving the chains, still running well with 8:20 to go in the third quarter. GAC leads 21-0. It's a 3-possession game. Whitenick to the left, Slayton to the right, lined up in an eye. GAC won't hand it off. Pass to Whitenick. Complete. He's wrapped up around the 40-yard line, but it will be enough for the first down. And we will move the chains. GAC, Whitenick clapping. He wanted more. He wanted to get yards after catch. He's very good at that. Catching, he's like a Wes Welker in that way, moving as soon as he catches it, cutting to his left around the defender, but the defender wrapped him up as soon as he caught it that time. Regardless, though, the first down was picked up with 7:54 left here in the third quarter. And you'll see Chapel flanked by Carruthers and Abernathy in the gun. Hand off to Abernathy, sweep to the right again, and he's picked up right past the 40-yard line as he is wrapped up again. Didn't work that time, so GAC trying to run the same plays they ran in the first half, and it's not going to work. Even though it did a couple of times, Model has picked up on it, and they're making the adjustments. Picked up one on that play. It's going to be a 2nd and 9. Ball on the 39-yard line. As Abernathy lined up again in the eye. Hands off. No, play action. Complete to Carruthers, down over the defender, all the way down close to the 25-yard line. It'll be about the 26, 27. That's going to be good for close to a first down. Tyler Dean on the tackle for the Modern Blue Devils.
but not before. First down for GAC and a good completion, a good play action fold to everyone again, including me. Complete to Carruthers, who hasn't run the ball yet today, but he's caught a couple of passes. Couple of receivers flanked to the left, one to the right. No handoff, good block. Complete to Lewis, the tight end, down to the 20, almost the 17-yard line, so a good pass. Lewis does catch it this time, no butterfingers, and move the chains again, and another great passing play and another good drive being put together by the GAC offense, as you see the, well, you don't see, but the Spartan down on the track. He's a very happy mascot right now. 21-0 lead, GAC, 6:40 to go in the third quarter of play. Again, GAC lining out in an I, model and nickel defense. Not a faked handoff into Abernathy, almost to the end zone, stretching. He won't make it, but he'll be down to about the 5, and a very good run again, sweeping to the left this time. With 6:25 to go, clock stopped. He was knocked out of bounds. Well, GAC in the red zone again. They've been perfect so far every time they've even been close to the goal line. Trying to take it to a 4-possession game with a 21-0 lead. Again, lining up in the eye. Look for either a play action or a handoff to Abernathy. A handoff to Abernathy, and he's in, but the flag on the play in the backfield looks like Chapel might have been hit late. The score looks like it might count. Flag is on the play. The points have not been put on the scoreboard yet, and no, that touchdown will not count. That's twice that's happened now for GAC. A complete pass all the way to a wide-open Peter Whiteneck, and there was a hold in the background. It looks like it's going to be the same thing this time, and it's going to move him back a good 10 yards. It's an unfortunate call right there as Abernathy cut to the left, cut a couple of defenders. He was in easily, and now they're going to have to do it all over again, a good 15, 20 yards from the goal line. Chapel lines up under center again. Slayton to his right, Whiteneck to his left. No handoff, rolling to his right. Doesn't see a man open, floats it, complete to Elrod, and he is in. He just put that one in. I don't know how. He threaded the needle in between two defenders, and Elrod right there for the catch. 27-0, your score, GAC, with a great drive, and that's a beautiful pass by Rafe Chapel. I didn't think he was going to try to put it in there, but he did right in between two model defenders. And Elrod there for the catch. 26-0 your lead. 5:47 to go in the third quarter. Brandon Holscreve set for the PAT. He's 3-for-3 so far tonight. And that one is blocked by Model, so that's a little bit of sign of life. As now it's only 26-0, but there's a flag on the play. Might have to redo this PAT attempt. Great block by Model, but it might not matter. You might have to line up and try to block it all over again. You will. It'll be an offsides call on Model, and you'll move even closer for Holscreve. So you're going to have to block it. He's not going to miss it 10 yards away from the goal line as he'll try it again. 3-for-3 tonight. See if Model can get around. They won't. That one is good, and it's 27-0, a 4-possession game. Here in the third quarter, GAC controlling on all cylinders, 5:47 to go in the third quarter. Model's going to get the ball. Right now you just really want to score. I know it's 27-0, but you just got to score. You don't want to be shut out, especially in the playoffs, and you want to salvage some kind of a good game that you can put together. And, again, that's going to have to come from the passing game. Nikhil Watkins kept running down 66, 70 yards every time. You're going to have to pass the ball, and Model just can't do it. They haven't done it yet. They're going to have to try. And Caleb Woods, he's passed it a few times, maybe 3 times in total. James Brown will be back. Look for another good return from him as he's had a couple tonight. Brandon Holscreve set to kick it away. Ball at the 40. He approaches, and there's the kick. He'll go back to Brown. He'll catch it on the 15. Fumbles again, but gets it back up. And he will be down around the 25. He's done that twice now tonight. Kicked it to him, catches, and he muffs it. Falls out of his hands. Luckily, he picked it up that time. No one was around him, and he salvaged at least a decent gain on a punt return, kickoff return. And now Model's offense will take the field again. GAC has shut them down tonight, and that's not a figure of speech. It's 28-0. 5:41 to go in the third. Caleb Woods, not under center. He is lining up to the left. Model coming out of the Wildcat. You'll see him snap right to Nikhil Watkins. There it is, sweeping to his left, and GAC stops it. It's not like they didn't see that coming. It was a direct snap to Nikhil Watkins. Woods to his left, and GAC right there to stop it. 5:25 to go, clock kicking in the third quarter. 28-0 lead for the Spartans of Greater Atlanta Christian High School. Austin Price flanked to the right. Woods now back under center. Nope. Actually, I think you're going to try a Wildcat again. And they do. Nikhil Watkins this time to his right. Gain of about 3 or 4. He'll get close to the 30-yard line. And when I say close, I mean a couple of yards away. It's going to be a third and maybe 6 or 7, maybe 5. And Model just can't get anything going on offense, and that's been the story all night long. A couple of Wildcats, that's something new you're trying, but it just didn't work. Jamal Milligan checks in now. Maybe you see him for a run. He's quicker. He can get around to that corner. Ball around the 32. Woods now back in the shotgun. Takes a snap. He's got a receiver open to the right, and he elects to go to his fullback to the left, and it is not caught. That's a 3 and out. And if you're Model, they are going to send the punting team on. 28-0, 4:12 to go in the third quarter. They're not going to go for it. They're going to send the punting unit on. Dax Bishop, who averages 9 tackles a game. He has not tonight, though. Hasn't really been a presence on defense. Had a couple of tackles. He will punt it away. Peter Whiteneck waiting along the 40-yard line. He'll punt it away. Bad snap. He will not get it off. He's hit as he punts it. Spartans waving it off. It'll roll all the way back close to the 35-yard line. And that's the second time Model has had a bad snap on a punt, and it looks like Bishop is down in the backfield. He was hit hard on the play. As the trainer will check on him in the backfield. It was just a bad snap. He tried to salvage anything. He did get a punt away. It went maybe 15 yards, but it rolled back to the 35. He's still down, and with that, we're going to take a quick injury timeout as they tend to Dax Bishop. Keep it here on Play On Sports. We'll be right back.
Powers on this.
back with you once again. GAC returning to the field. They will take over in an eye. Dax Bishop was helped off the field limping. Took a hard hit after that punt attempt. As you see Chapel with a handoff to Abernathy that time. Get about 2, 3, maybe 4 yards, a little bit past the 35-yard line. I beg your pardon. Very nice gesture by the GAC Spartans, though, as Bishop was being helped off the field. The entire team huddled over on the sideline, saying a prayer, hoping that he is not injured too badly. Great sign of respect shown from GAC, who leads 28-0 here in this third quarter. 3:25 to go. There's a pitch to the left. Corey Stevenson, first action he's seen today as he picks up maybe one or two. It'll get close to the 30. And it'll be a third down for the GAC Spartans. They have not picked up a first down in this drive. Stevenson, first run we've seen from him today. Still no Kyle Scales. No Kyle Scales at all tonight. But now Chapel drops back in the shotgun. Stevenson flanked to his left. No handoff. Looks. He finds Darius Slayton. He's hit hard, but the catch, he holds on, and he will make the catch at the 25. Move the chains. A first down for GAC. A great route run by Slayton that time. That's the first catch he's had today. Great pass by Chapel to put it in there again amongst the defenders. Has to whip it in, and he does. There goes Elrod checking back off. He's already got a touchdown catch tonight, along with Peter Whiteneck. Darius Slayton, the only one that doesn't. Whiteneck flanked to his left, Slayton to his right. They line up in an eye. Fakes the handoff to Stevenson. Pass complete. Can't tell what number that is, but he got almost all the way down to the 10, maybe the 8-yard line, as that was Lewis, the tight end with a great catch. A couple of catches on him tonight. Chapel trying to get everyone involved here on the passing play. Gain of about 5 or 6. And they'll take it along the 7-8 yard line. That was actually a first down. And they'll line up in an eye again. Hand off to Stevenson. Cut left. Deep. And he will get in, and Model unable to stop him. He cut left, and then he cut right, avoiding all the defenders. And it is now 35-0 GAC. Greater Atlanta Christian almost has this game in their pocket at this point. It's 35-0. They'll bring on the kicking team. Brandon Holscreef has been perfect, but actually a flag on the play, and GAC will have to go all the way back. This is 3 times this has happened now. GAC gets in the end zone, and then a flag's thrown. Unfortunate again for them. Still 28-0, 1:49 to go in the third quarter. Great job by Stevenson with a run, but it won't go in the record books at all because of the flag. And now Rafe Chapel back in the shotgun again. Stevenson to his right, couple of receivers to his left, one to his right. He's looking left. Pass complete to Whiteneck, down to the 10. And that'll be good for another GAC first down. Good passing attack by GAC tonight. Great rushing as well as Mike Abernathy. Looks like he's taking the night off or a couple of drives as Chapel is really just passing happy all over. Darius Slayton, Lewis. Now Whiteneck in on this one. Elrod's the only one that hasn't. Back in the gun again. 2 receivers to his left, 1 to the right. Flanks to his left. The pitch to Stevenson. He's got all day. Tries to get in. Gets all the way down to about the 2-yard line. A good run. Chapel faked it. Tried to take it himself. Drew the defense and a perfect pitch to his left. And Stevenson, in between a couple of defenders, gets all the way down to the 2-yard line. And a good run, and another flag is what we'll see as GAC is just shooting themselves in the foot right now with these good runs and good passes, and then they just get a flag. Another hold. Not sure who it was on, but GAC moving back again. They'll just have to do it again. 40 seconds to go here in the third quarter. You might see them just – they'll run one more play, and then it's ticked down. We'll begin the fourth quarter. GAC leading 28-0. Two receivers to his right, one to his left. He's coming out of the gun. Pass to Whiteneck, complete, down, trying to find room, all the way down to the two. He will get out of bounds. The clock will actually stop with 9.9 left. That's not what you want if you're model. You just want it to run down, but it's 9.9 left, and GAC will have one more chance to huddle up and possibly get in the end zone again. Whiteneck off the field now for the first time tonight. And they break. Chapel still out of the shock. Nope, he will line up in the I formation. No receivers. The handoff to Stevenson. He is stopped, and that will be the end of the third quarter. It's going to tick down. 28-0, your lead. GAC, they're going to switch to the opposite end of the field, trying to get it in on the red zone again. They've been perfect so far tonight, despite the penalties. We're going to take a quick break here on Play On Sports, bring it right back for the beginning of the fourth quarter, though, with GAC leading 28-0. Back with you once again. Play On Sports beginning the fourth and final quarter of this game. Greater Atlanta Christian leads 28-0. And that's the first play of the fourth quarter. Handoff to Micah Abernathy is back in. He will be picked up just right past the line of scrimmage. He won't pick up much on that one. 11:46 to go now. It's the beginning of the fourth quarter. GAC leads 28-0. For all the live scoring and highlights of all the game Play On does, sports is covering, go to www.playonsports.com/footballplayoffs. That's www.playonsports.com/footballplayoffs, and you can follow us on Facebook and Twitter at Play On Sports or hashtag GHSA Football. Looks like they're going to measure this one. Abernathy just past the line of scrimmage. They're measuring to see if he got the first down. He did not. Model very excited about that as they have a stop. That's the first time GAC has not scored being down in their red zone. And they will bring on Brandon Holscreve to try for a field goal. I beg your pardon, that was actually a fourth down attempt for GAC. Don't know why they went for it on fourth. And that's a turnover, and Model will take over on the goal line. Caleb Woods and the Model offense backed up all the way to the goal line. There's the handoff to Watkins. And he is dropped right at the line of scrimmage again, maybe 1 yard past. 11:28 to go in the fourth quarter and final play. 28-0 your lead. GAC Spartans well in control of this game. Second and eight. He did pick up two yards on that one as Woods with another handoff. Nope, he keeps it himself. Throw deep, and the receiver fell. Austin Price was open, but he fell down. Don't know if he was pushed down by Darius Slayton or if the AstroTurf tripped him up. But he was wide open. If he catches it, he's all the way down the field for the first touchdown and score of the game for the Model Blue Devils. But he just fell down, and that's been the story. That's been the kind of night it has been for Model. 10:58 to go here in the fourth quarter. It'll be a third down. And at this point, you might have to see him. I don't know if you want to punt it back there, but it's four down play. Nikhil Watkins lined up. Keeps it himself. Woods, and he is sacked in the end zone for a safety. Tack on two more points. Actually, he might have been down right at the goal line. They're not going to give him a safety. It's very kind by the officials there. It looked like he was tackled right in the end zone, but they will be down on the 1 yard line, and any further back, and the punter might be right on the line. We'll see how they handle this as a couple of snaps have gone awry. Here's the snap. It's actually a good one. Punt it away. It'll roll down to the 30. Whiteneck picks it up. Get down to the 30, 35, 20, and he'll go down out of bounds around the 20-yard line. Good return. Of course, any return was going to be good if you're returning it from the 30, as that was one of the most productive punts we've seen from Model tonight, as a couple have gone awry on just bad snaps, and GAC is just really taking advantage of it, and that's what they're going to plan on doing here, taking the ball around the 20-yard line. With a 28-0 lead, 9:59 to go in the fourth quarter. Chapel out of the shotgun formation. Abernathy flanked to his left. Carruthers to his right. Lead again. 9:59 to go, fourth quarter. Chapel still on the field. Abernathy to his right. There's the handoff to Abernathy. To his right. Cuts the corner. And he is picked up around the 10, maybe 9-yard line. Gets the first down and then some. And if they score one more time, you might see the subs come in, as normally in a high school game, it's a 28-0 lead. You see the subs come in. There's really no reason you rest your starters for the next week. And Chapel still in the gun. Abernathy lined up to his right. Darius Slayton to his right. Whiteneck to his left, as well as Elrod. The pass to Whiteneck, and he is in. Another touchdown for the GAC Spartans. 34-0 lead to Greater Atlanta Christian. 9:45 left to go in the fourth quarter. Chapel, fourth passing touchdown on the night. Second caught by Peter Whiteneck, and Brandon Holscreve will be on for the PAT. Oh, that's actually Will Kenworthy. And Kenworthy, a low snap, but he gets it through, and it's 35-0 with 9:45 left in the fourth quarter. Model's going to get the ball back. You really just want to score if you're Model. You do not want to be shut out in the playoffs. The first time you've reached the playoffs since 2003. before that, they had not reached the playoffs since 1997. So it's not usual for the Blue Devils to be in this type of situation, but you just really want to score. I don't know what you say if you're the coach on the sideline right now. Keep your heads high. You're playing your heart out. And Holzgrief will line it up to kick it away. It will not be James Brown in the backfield to make the catch this time. That will be Caleb Woods, the quarterback slash defensive back. Nikhil Watkins also back there. And Holzgrief set to kick it away. And there is the kick, handled by Caleb Woods. Down the 15, the 20, the 25, and he's going to be down right around the 29-yard line. About a 20-yard punt return, kick return, and clock's ticking, 9:29 to go in the fourth. 35-0 lead for the GAC Spartans. The model offense will take the field for what might be the final time, depending on how long this drive lasts. And lined up in the shotgun formation, as expected in this point in the game. Caleb Woods pass over the middle, intended for his fullback, VJ Saxton, the sophomore. But he just overthrew him, and if GAC is up a little bit further, they might have an interception and return it for a pick six. But it'll go down as an incomplete pass in the books, and we'll have a second and 10. Look for Mono to continue to come out of the shotgun formation, as you really have to pass, something I was saying all game. 8:26 to go here in the fourth. Three receivers to his left, one to his right. Takes the snap, fakes the pass, takes it himself down to the 30, the 35, 40, and he's pushed out of bounds around the 45-yard line by the GAC defense. That was Ross Wood on the tackle. And that's a good gain by Caleb Woods there. You're not going to pass. You don't have anyone open. Take it yourself. And he did a good job of getting out of bounds, too, to stop the clock. 8:06 to go here in the fourth, 35-0. Your lead, GAC advantage. You have everyone lined up as a wide receiver now. Saxton to his right, two to his left. He's looking. He's looking. He has a wide open down in the 20-yard line, and Woods takes it himself again. Austin Price had no one around him. He was waving, jumping up and down. He was wide open down at the 20-yard line, and Woods just didn't see him. Instead, he takes himself all the way down to about the 49-yard line, and clock still running, 7:40 to go here in the game. Woods still out of the shotgun formation, three receivers to his left, one to his right. Takes a snap, low pass, caught though. Actually, wasn't caught. He caught it on a bounce, tried to sell it to the official, but he was right there for the call. And it'll be another second and 10 from the 49 with 7:23 to go in the fourth. Saxton again lining up as a wide receiver to his right. Flanked by a couple of backs. Takes the snap. Looking for anyone. Pass across the middle intended for Price off his hands. Another incomplete pass for the Model Blue Devils, and it'll be a third down, 7:19 to go. It's four down territory, though. Even if you don't get it on third, you're going for it on fourth. And it's 35-0. Incomplete pass did stop the clock. Yet Carrick Culberson lined up to his right as well as Saxton. Austin Price and Jamal Milligan to the left. He's feeling the pressure. Rolling out to his right. Still got a pass. And he goes down right around the 49-yard line. He was looking for anyone open. Had an open Carrick or Culberson down the field, but he just didn't pass it. He'll go down. Gain of about four on the play. And he'll actually go off the field. They're not going to go for it on fourth. Unless they do a wildcat formation where they just hike it straight to the running back. It looks like Model. That was fourth down. Beg your pardon, I lost my count. Now GAC takes over at the 50. Under center now, that was Jack McLaughlin. Tries to get a handoff, but right when he hands it off to Stevenson, it was tackled. So now you do see the subs coming in for the Spartans. As McLaughlin is a junior quarterback, also serves as a defensive back. He'll line up in the shotgun formation. So GAC not even afraid to throw it with 35. Point advantage. Two receivers to his right, one to his left. Handoff. He'll get down to about the 47-yard line that time. A good run. That was Jalen Venable, the sophomore. It's good to see a couple of subs coming in for GAC, getting some playing time that they normally wouldn't. Maybe the future of this program. Venable, the sophomore, with a good run that time. Move the chains, new set of downs. As McLaughlin has two receivers to his right again, one to his left. Keeps it himself, looking for an open defender. Beg your pardon, open receiver, and it was almost intercepted by Model. That would be Austin Price. But I do not know what the call was on that play, but it looked like an incomplete pass. But it's actually now been called an interception. So Model has forced his first turnover of the game, and they will take over on the 35-yard line. No dispute from the GAC coaches. He's got a 35-point lead. Woods takes the snap, complete to Culberson, and he is down around the 40-yard line. That's the first nice completion for Woods and the Model offense all day, and that goes down to the 40-yard line, gain of about five. It'll be a second and five with Culberson lining up now to the left. Actually, he will be heading out of bounds. Woods, two backs, two receivers to his left, one to his right. Actually, that's Cameron O'Neill is checked in. Thinks about throwing, takes it himself, keeps it himself, still on his feet. He's going to run, and he takes down all the way to the 35-yard line, opposite side of the 50. And if he doesn't trip up, he is in the end zone, and Model is on the board for the first time tonight. Cameron O'Neill, yes, in now at quarterback for the Model Blue Devils. Biggest run of the night for the Blue Devils. Comes from the backup quarterback. He gets down to about the 34. Now O'Neill still back under center. Three receivers to his left. Complete to Price. Still working down. Down to the 20. Down to about the 9-yard line. A good completion and an even better yards after carry. Yards after catch, for Austin Price. First catch of the day for Price, and he gets all the way down to the 9-yard line. So Cameron O'Neill showing he's not afraid to throw it, and he's pretty consistent. 4:42 to go in the fourth, 35-0 lead for the GAC Spartans. A little too late for the Blue Devils, but this is something to build upon during the offseason. Maybe you have a competition for quarterback as O'Neill with a pass. Almost complete. In and out of the hands. Let's see who that receiver was intended for. That was Caleb Woods. who was serving his quarterback the entire game, and he drops out in the slot to the right as a wide receiver is in and out of his hands. Good defense. As the first time Pickens has had to do anything back in the free safety position, he was able to knock it away. And it's second and 10. Cameron O'Neill back in the shotgun again. Defender in his face does get rid of it. That's going to be for about a loss, though. He's going to get down to about the 14-yard line, close to the 13. That was the first catch for Jamal Milligan on the day, the sophomore running back, now serving as a wide receiver. Was for a loss. Cameron O'Neill back in the shotgun. Milligan in motion to his right. Whistle blown, though. Flag on the play. See what it was for. Clock has stopped. 3:54 to go in the fourth quarter. Not sure. Looks like the call might have been on model. Yes. Might have been a false start on the offensive line, and they're going to move back to the 30-yard line. That's the last thing you want for the Model Blue Devils. Cameron O'Neill back in after getting the play. The ball will actually be around the 25, 26-yard line. Beg your pardon. It's a third and long. Cameron O'Neill, that was a design run. Pitches it to Watkins. He's going to get down to close to the 15-yard line, and he's going to be knocked down, still fighting. Finally knocked down. And you're definitely going to see Model go for it here on fourth down. No reason to bring in the kicking team. You really want to score at least once in this game. O'Neill getting the play from Gordon Powers on the sideline. 3:27 to go. Fourth and 12. Doesn't matter the yardage, though. They were going to go for this either way. Nikhil Watkins lined up to his left. Final play for Model. Pass. Complete. He just short of the goal line. As Austin Price right there with a great catch, but right on the goal line. Actually knocked out as he was hit by the great GAC defense. And you're going to see the offense come back on. And they will milk the clock. They're surely going to run the ball. 3:05 left to go. 3 timeouts for both teams. Not many timeouts called today, but Model's going to have to use all of its timeouts unless it wants to just let GAC milk the clock down. It's 3:05. 35-point lead for the Spartans. McLaughlin still in at quarterback. He actually keeks it himself all the way down. Complete to Corey Stevenson. And he is down all close to the – that was actually Kenny Griffin, one of the subs, down to the 45-yard line. So I was wrong. They're not going to run the ball. It's 2:55 to go. They'll move the chains. Like Model might have used the timeout. Not sure. The clock did stop, though, as – McLaughlin with a very good pass to Kenny Griffin that time. It's 2:50. There goes the clock. 2:50 to go. Lined up in an eye, the GAC offense. Receiver to his right and his left. Handoff and knocked down as soon as the ball reaches him. That ball handed to Jalen Venable, who had a good run earlier, but he's hit as soon as he hands it off. And now 2:28 to go. 15 on the play clock. GAC just going to milk this down. Now a new play clock, 22 to go. Still ticking, 2:08. 2 minutes, 8 seconds left to go in this game. GAC still lining up in an eye. He takes the pitch. Working around to his right, still on his feet. finally dragged down. That was Trey Nelson, first carry of the day. Pitched to McLaughlin's right, to his left, I beg your pardon, and now minute 42 to go. Looks like a GAC offensive lineman is down, Britt Lee. Lee in on a lot of tackles early on in the season. Not good to see him down, but with another injury timeout. A reminder that you can follow us on Facebook and Twitter at PlayOnSports, hashtag GHSA Football, or you can join the conversation about high school sports by following us there. With this timeout, they're going to tend to Britt Lee on the field, so keep it here. Minute 37 to go in the game. GAC clinging to a 35-point advantage. We'll be right back. Back with you. Britt Lee was helped off the field successfully on his own feet, though. That's a good sign as you look for him to play next week. In on a lot of tackles, as I said, a really strong presence on defense as well as on offense. As the handoff again knocked down Trey Nelson as soon as the ball hits him. Minute 5 to go on the clock. So now you might see one more play and then maybe take a knee, or they might just go ahead and take a knee. The GAC Spartans, they're going to win this one 35-0. Not what you're looking for model, but a couple of signs to look for heading into the offseason, heading into next season. You made the playoffs for the first time since 2003 under head coach Gordon Powers in his first year, so something was done right. Cameron O'Neill has showed tonight that he is a force to be reckoned with, especially passing and scrambling. He's very fast. Might have a competition for quarterback coming off in the off season. There's the handoff to Trey Nelson again. Knocked down right at the 35, a loss of about 4 or 5 on the play. 23 seconds left to go in the game. Going to have a new set of downs, I believe. It might have been a turnover. That might have been a fourth down or might have been a timeout to stop the clock. 23 seconds again to go here. Fourth quarter, GAC leads 35-0. Model will take over, so we will see a couple of plays. They're not going to take a knee. Sends a receiver in motion to his left. O'Neill on his run to the left, complete to Saxton, down almost to the 33-yard line. You might see a hurry-up offense here with the 13 seconds to 11 seconds to go. He was either knocked out of bounds or Model used one of their three timeouts because the clock has stopped. 11 seconds to go here in the game, this playoff matchup between the Greater Atlanta Christian Spartans and the Blue Devils of Model High School. Model had a great season, 6-4, very impressive. GAC was just too strong and too powerful. They overpowered them in every way, offense and defense tonight, with a 35-0. But Model can still get on the board here, salvage something. You don't want to be shut out in the playoffs. I've said it about 5 times tonight. You do not want to be shut off, shut out, especially in the postseason. Cameron O'Neill back on the field. in the shotgun formation. Four receiver set. Complete. Caught by Milligan down to the 29, 28-yard line. Clock stop again. So it looks like Model is using its timeouts to stop the clock because he's not going out of bounds. And GAC is just electing to stay on the field. Send the same defense that they've been sending all night long. 4 seconds to go. This looks like it might be the last play of the game. The Model Blue Devils trying to get in the end zone, trying to at least get on the board in some way. And this right here is the season for the Model Blue Devils. 4 seconds, 35-0 score. Out of the shotgun formation, Cameron O'Neill takes the snap, rolling to his right. Complete to Austin Price, and he is in the end zone. And how about that? Model on the board. 35-6, so Model does score. Absolutely no time left on the clock. That is fantastic for Model. You've clearly lost the game, but you definitely don't want to go out without scoring any. And looks like they're not even going to kick the field goal. The time ran out on the clock, and that is your ball game. GAC, the Greater Atlanta Christian Spartans, will advance next week to play the winner of another game in Division 2A tonight. 35-6, your final score. Again, the GAC Spartans with the win. They will advance further in the playoffs. Season over for the Model Blue Devils, but don't hang your heads. This has been Ben Poplin for Play On Sports. Thank you, and tune in next week for another matchup, Georgia High School Football.